Hey, Fright Fest Television here, and we're with Milan Todorovic, director of Nymph, a Serbian film. So there. Milan, tell us all about it. I mean, you know, glad to have you at Fright Fest. Good for coming. I mean, The Little Mermaid done as a horror, is that as simple as it gets? Is that the guest explanation for this?
Yeah, that's it.
All right, that's it. Yeah. End off. No. So why do this one? Is it of mermaids anything specifically to do with your area? I mean, is it a specific legend?
Well, actually, we started making a movie about that island because I like the island a lot and I always wanted to make a movie there. And I even had some stories before, but not really a story that would connect to the island so essentially, you know. So when I heard this story from a friend of mine that he had about a mermaid trapped below that island, I was like, yeah, let's do that. I mean, it was, I think, just an accident that it was a mermaid because there is no mermaid stories in Serbia. I mean, Serbia is not even on the sea, you know, so. But as soon as I heard the story, and I was like, yeah, there are not too many horror movies with mermaids. Actually, I haven't seen any movie with mermaid except from Little Mermaid and maybe Pirates of the Caribbean. The last one, so I that was interesting enough for me to step into the production of this film, and it was we did really really fast. You know, it was like 3 months after I heard the idea, we were filming.
So, what was the original story going to be set on the island then? If you hadn't, you know, you were gonna, what was that story without the mermaid?
No, that was the story was with the mermaid when I heard it.
Ah.
Before I had some ideas for another movies, but I never developed them.
Oh, okay. So that particular island, the prison island, then,
yeah.
Is it a famous sort of location in your neck of the woods?
It's because it's a very popular touristic place on the coast. So every time I go there for a holiday, I see the island and it looks very filmic. You know, it's very exotic location and it's totally unused. I mean, it's not even a museum, although the concentration camp was there and, you know, it has a lot of history. And I was always thinking, why do they not make like a tour or what, to use that island for something?
Yeah, but hang on a minute, you know, here I am on my summer holidays, let's go and visit a concentration camp. Well, you know what I mean?
Yeah, but it's like a place of a long history, you know. Not only that, they can tell stories about Second World War, about communism, about, you know, things, because there was also one older movie called Mamula Camp. And it was a movie about the prisoners in that island. That's like two movies with that island. My movie and that was like 54, I think. That was the year. And it was black and white and stuff. And I even wanted to use the footage from that movie like a flashback of the island, you know. So, and I was watching the movie, but there was no... It was different type of framing the film, so I couldn't really use anything to do it like when they enter some place to have like a flashback on black and white scene with the prisoners walking. There was no similar shots, you know, so I dropped the idea at the end.
I mean, obviously going into a mermaid picture, you realise you're going to have to do some sort of special effects. I mean, did you worry about that, thinking we couldn't afford them, or you had to get them really well done, and there was that side of it?
Well, when I heard the story about mermaid, I was like, okay, but we don't have money, this is a low-budget movie, how are we going to make the mermaid killing people all the time? So then I come up with the idea to have a slave killing for her for the first half of the movie, you know, so that was like the substitution for the mermaid. At the end, we had these practical effects done by Miroslav Lakobrija, who did a Serbian film, that Serbian film, and also he did my first film, Apocalypse of the Dead, and some other movies, and he did the practical part of the mermaid, and the tail was done in CGI, and I was kind of worried at the beginning because we were shooting only 16 days, the entire movie. So we had this mermaid, and I didn't really know how is she going to look, how it's going to end up, you know. And she was like crawling in jeans, you know. And it was like a strange thing to watch and direct, you know. But it was fun. At the end, I think it looked really good with the CGI at the end. It was done well.
So how did you get Franco Nero involved? He doesn't do that much these days. So how did you get him involved?
Well, as I said, we were preparing the movie really fast, and then I told the writers to make one character to be like a special guest, like a known actor, and to be there just for like 2 days of shooting because we couldn't afford him more. At the end, he was there more, but the thing is, I heard that Franco Nero is going to be at Grossman Film and Wine Festival, and I was there in the jury of a Melies competition, and I told writers, write this character for Franco Nero. So I went there and I met him, and he was like, I don't do cameos, it's I did one in Croatia, it was terrible, and I don't like it, doing it, and so on. But then he was looking at my girlfriend all the time, and I was like, stop it, you know. And he was like, yeah, he was talking to her most of the time, and at the end he said, okay, send me the script. So I sent the script, and he answers him, like, day after, saying, I don't like it. It's not what I expected, but here's my phone number, call me. I was like, okay, so I call him, he says, hey, Milan, okay, so, not that I don't like it, but I have some ideas. I was like, okay, tell me. So he told me the new ideas for his character, and he practically changed the entire character, but it was much better this way. I liked it much more. It was more connected to the stories and to the prologue scene, and had more motivation to the things that he does. Originally, he was supposed to be the brother of the killer, but but he changed that. And I really like what he changed, and he was really great on the set, helped me a lot. He was there for 2-3 days, but we had bad weather, we had electricity loss, we had a lot of problems, and he says, no, I'm here until we shoot the thing, so don't worry. So he stayed a couple days more, and we were shooting with him more. And he was also insisting on doing some stuff that are not really safe, but looked great, you know, like when he's doing the thing on the boat, it was really storm outside, and he said, no, it will look great on the screen. So he insisted to do all those scenes, and it really looked much better. Imagine the scene, he's on the still water doing like, oh, the mermaid is coming, but this was like big waves and everything, you know. So it was really my honor and my great experience to work with him.
What about the other cast? I mean, you've worked with Christina Klee before. I mean, yeah. I know she was in Apocalypse of the Dead. The other, you know, like Natalie, I mean, where did you find these people?
Natalie I met in Cannes, 2 weeks before we decided to make a movie. And actually, I was on her birthday party, and I came there without a present, and I was drunk, and I was like, oh, I don't have anything to give it to. So I took a piece of paper, so I wrote the contract, and I was like, here, Milan saying that you will be my next film. So I signed it. She was like, yay. And then, like, 2 weeks later, we were like, who are we going to cast in this? I was like, let's call that girl, you know. So I called her, and I was like, this is the time for your birthday present, and she was very happy to be in the movie. And
wow.
Yeah. Also, if I didn't make the movie with her, she could sue me.
Yes. Wow. Because she's in the Expendables 3, isn't
yeah,
she?
Yeah, well, she shot Expendables 3 during filming of Nymph. So she had a 3 days break. She went to the set to Bulgaria. She came back. She says, oh, I got the part in Expendables. So she finished the Nymph. She go back to Bulgaria, did the Expendables, and that's...
Oh, wow.
Yeah, and also with Christina was a great thing to work again, and I really liked her, what she did in Zone of the Dead, so Apocalypse of the Dead. And she was the first one to be contacted to be in it. Also, the killer was also in Apocalypse of the Dead.
Mm-hmm.
He was Ken Foree's partner.
Oh, yes, because that's the... Yes.
Yeah.
Your film that we love so much. I mean, 16 days, not very long.
It was really hard, because when you film on the sea... You cannot predict anything, you know, because you put the boat on one place and like 5 minutes later, the boat is there. So you put lights, boat moves, storm comes, boat detaches from the anchors, you know. We had to go to the island is without electricity. So when we finish shooting, it's pitch black. I mean, it's outside, you cannot see the sea. And one day it was like a big storm and we couldn't leave the island. So we were sitting all on the island, it was so cold and scary, you know. And we left like hours later, and then one day our boat got on fire. You know, we were coming back from the island, and then the smoke came out of the engine, and I was like, just hold the tapes. So I was like, you know, save the tapes.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so it was like an adventure, you know. It was really difficult, and we had really small crew, small number of days, but everybody gave their best, so I think we managed somehow to make it, you know. And even Franco said, one of the reasons I came is because I read the script, and it was like 30 pages of final scenes and sequence, and you're supposed to do it in 2 days. I mean, I wanted to see how are you going to do it, you know? We did it.
I mean, the film's opened, hasn't it? I mean, you had it's been on in your country already.
Yes.
And has it been a success? Did it do well?
It was so-so. I mean, because it's in English and it's a, you know, horror film, but it was much better than American horrors, but not as good as Serbian comedies, you know, or some other Serbian films. Dramas, or I mean, not dramas, but you know, like popular comedies.
Mm-hmm.
They did much, much better, but it was okay. I kind of like it. And also, it's going theatrical in Philippines.
Oh.
Yeah. And then they put it on the poster based on true events. And they have mermaid on the poster. What? What true events? You know?
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So what are you going to do next? What's up? What's up? Are you going to stay in the genre? Are you going to still do it?
Yes, so far. I'm preparing the sequel to Apocalypse of the Dead. And
my blood runs cold.
Yeah. Well, you'll like it.
You said that about the last one.
Yeah.
So that's what you're doing.
Yeah, I think
another zombie film.
Yeah,
essentially.
I mean, there is interest from distributors and from sales to do the sequel, and I'm also Franco Nero actually liked the Nymph so much he himself wrote the treatment for the synopsis for the sequel. So if this one goes well, maybe that will be the next one actually. And his ideas are again really good, and I like the story. So if we do the sequel of Nymph, that would be Franco's storyline. And also, another film I'm developing with Franco, it will be like a crime story, like a Death Wish kind of thing, so...
Wow, it sounds like a fortuitous meeting. It sounds like you're doing everything with Franco Nero.
Yeah, I always fell in love with my actors, you know, so I did two movies with Christina, Natalie will be in Zone of the Dead sequel, I'm producing another movie with Ken Foree now, and I mean, you know, I like working with them again, I don't know why.
Wow. Well, listen, thank you. I mean, other thing was, Serbia doesn't really have any sort of tradition in horror, or do they? Am I imagining it? Are you the gleaming light?
Yeah, well, there is one older director who did a lot of kind of horror movies, but they're just more like dramas with that horror atmosphere. Mm. He had some, you know, like, they're more like thrillers with horror gothic atmosphere, and they're pretty good. And for modern ages, let's say, for modern days, I'm the only one practically doing it. I mean, there are like a few movies that circle the horror festivals, and they're like considered like a genre films, like a Serbian film and Life and Death of Porn Gang. But they're like more thriller dramas than really actual horror films, you know.
Mm,
I think
sure.
I'm the only one, yeah. And also it's very hard to make a genre film in Serbia because most of the films are funded from state, and state commissions doesn't even read the genre films. When they read a mermaid movie, they, you know, they throw the screenplay in the can. So when we showed them the finished material, they actually gave us for Nymph some money for post-production because they really liked it. And I think that's actually the way how Serbia can open up to wider audience, you know, to show genre films, to produce, I mean, to support them. And then it will reach wider audience, you know, it will be distributed in the UK, in the USA, and all over the world, I mean, for the genre fans, but at the end they will end up watching some other Serbian film, you know, they will hear about the movies coming from Serbia. You know, although a Serbian film was like a anti-Serbian film, but people heard about the name, you know, so they know there are like movies coming from Serbia. Also, I saw some clips from US of like reviewers, kids doing it, and they were like, oh, we just saw Apocalypse of the Dead, it's a zombie film coming from Serbia, we didn't even know that Serbia makes movies, but they have zombie film, you know. So I think that's the way, how one of the ways that Serbian films can reach wider audience.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.